Hi, Rafa.
Hello, Paul.
What are we going to see today?
Well, I'm going to explain a little bit what is a digital signature, and also to make a demonstration about the integration that we have done here with the digital signature and Nuxeo, that is this document management system.
Okay, digital signature. Are these type of signatures as valid as your traditional handwritten signature?
In fact, they are more valid, because it's very simple. A traditional signature is a writing on a paper. It can be very easily forged. Mm-hmm. The other way, and the other side, we have the digital signature. That is a code which identifies the person uniquely.
Uh-huh. I see. And you are going to you're going to show us how this works by signing something like that.
Exactly. I'm going to choose a document.
This is a document that you already have in Nuxeo, right?
Exactly. Okay. And now the signing format we use is the PDF format. Okay. I'm going to explain this because, as you can see here, we have an ODT file. Okay. An ODT from OpenOffice. Because we use the PDF format signing, there are many different kinds of formats for signing, XML, digital signature. What we do here is, if we want to sign a file that is not a PDF, we make a transformation before signing the document.
Okay, so does the user have to convert it himself?
No, it's totally automatic.
Okay.
Well, as you can see here, we have the digital signature tab.
I see. The digital signature tab appeared when you chose any document.
Any document, okay. Exactly.
I see.
So, which is this tab? Okay. And now here we have the sign button. As you can see, it's very easy. You have only one button for signing. We click on it. We can see the certificates that we can use for signing the document.
All right.
Here we are going to choose. Well, these certificates are extracted from the Firefox certificate store.
Okay, and they have been imported.
Exactly.
Right,
they have to be imported before. So we choose, for example, mine, this one, and we click on signed, and it's as easy as you can see. The document is signed. You can see here the person who signed the document, the date in which the document was signed, and the expiration date of the certificate.
And is there? I imagine that the signature is something that you this type of signature is something that you don't normally see. But is there anything that we visually can see when we open the document?
I want to explain this because it's something people can cannot. They maybe have some problems with it. I mean, this image here in the document, it doesn't mean that the document is signed.
Okay,
the digital signature is something more complex. It's a code which identifies the person and the document. This is only an image here showing that it is signed, but it can be or it cannot be there. I mean, so doesn't mean that it is signed.
Okay. You would have to use a special kind of software to check that it is signed.
Exactly.
Okay. And does this mean that, so if we have a document with several pages, does it mean that all the pages have been signed?
Exactly. When you sign a document, let's say you have a code which represents the entire document, all the pages. So if you, for example, modify the document, this code changes. So you can detect also any difference between the original document and the document if it has been modified.
So you really cannot manipulate.
Exactly.
Okay, I see. So even if we change some text inside the document?
Exactly. We can detect with the digital signature, we can detect any change in the document.
Right. One comma, you could detect that.
Any change. I want to show you something also about the digital signature. Apart from the certificates we have in the Firefox store, we can use smart cards.
Okay.
This, for example, I'm going to use the Spanish ID card, which is a card which contains two certificates, one for signing and another one for authentic. We put the card into the card reader, and when we click sign, it has to load the certificates. It will take a while because the first time it has to load the certificates, and now we will be able to sign with the certificates from the card. Here we have the PIN window.
I see, and it gives you a PIN window, so you have to write in your special password that you have associated with your own card.
Exactly. For example, if I lose the card, anyone could sign for me. No, you need a password, a special password, in order to access the certificates inside the card. Okay. In this case, I'm going to write mine here. And after loading, we can see the additional certificates which appear here.
I see, it's from the police.
Exactly.
Right, which are the people who give you the card.
Exactly.
Okay.
In this case, is the Spanish ID card. Okay. Here we click on the firma, which means sign in Spanish. And we click on sign. This advert tells me that the certificate can be expired or cannot be valid. Okay, let's say something. For example, inside this card we have two certificates, but these certificates expire before the card.
Okay,
the card expires in 5 years, the certificates in 2.5 years. So it tells you here. We click on yes, and this is a window which appears anytime you use the Spanish ID card.
Right, it's a warning.
Yeah,
right?
A warning. This is only for the Spanish ID card, this window. If you use another smart card, the window can be different.
Okay.
I click accept. And we have the signature done.
Okay.
As you can see, it's very easy. Here we have the other document signed. You can see here that both names are mine because the certificates are mine.
Okay, but one of them has actually got a number associated with it, that is the number of your ID card.
Exactly.
Right. Okay, so I can start to imagine the advantages, but for example, could you, for example, get a batch of documents and sign them all at the same time? Say, take 100 documents and sign them all?
Yeah. Yeah, this is one of the advantages of the digital signature.
Yes.
You can have, a batch of documents, 100 documents, and sign it at once.
Yes, and you obviously don't have to print anything. The document,
no.
You can send it by email and it's going to
be exactly.
Signed. Yes.
The traditional signature, it can be a very high cost for companies. I mean, it's the paper, it's the printing, the ink, the printers, and also the traditional mail. When you have to sign a contract or an invoice, whatever, then maybe you have to send it through the traditional post mail.
Yeah.
It can be a very high cost for the company.
Yes, and I suppose this helps productivity also. I mean, it's not so slow.
Exactly. It can be very. The productivity of a company can be very increased with the digital signature.
Okay, it's very interesting. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Paul.
Okay, bye.